Hello and welcome to SoCal Prep Report with Eric Sonheimer of the Los Angeles Times. My name is Randy Rosenblum. Well, we're at Birmingham High School in Lake Balboa. The Patriots, the top seed in the open division of the LA City Section, into the finals, Eric. They were terrific in their win over Taft. They'll face Westchester on Saturday at Cal State Dominguez Hills. Westchester got by Fairfax. They had lost two games to Fairfax during the year. But let's first talk about this team, Birmingham, and what they had to do to fend off Antoine January and beat the Toreadors for the fourth time.
Yeah, beating a team four times in the year, I don't care who it is, it's a tough task. And Taft came at them. They fell behind by 19 points, and they got within six, I believe. And so Birmingham had to really do well. But, of course, they have so many scores, a team of five scores in the starting lineup. That's why they're the number one seed, and that's why I think they're going to win it on Saturday, their versatility, and their also ability to play some pressure defense when they need to.
Yeah, their defense was outstanding in the semifinals, although you had to be impressed with Antoine January, the 6'9", sophomore, maybe junior. That's still being disputed.
No, he's not a sophomore.
He's listed as a sophomore.
He's listed as a sophomore. If it was a sophomore, that would be pretty impressive. But anyway, he did a great job in the second half. Had 0 points though in the first half. And I think that's when the game was pretty much decided. And Taft will be a great team next year. They got a lot of good young players. But in the end, Birmingham's experience, it was too much. And with the Dutree brothers, you worry about one and then the other hurts you, and that's why Birmingham is so versatile.
Westchester a win over Fairfax 66-59 after losing the two games in the regular season to the Lions.
Yeah, this was a game I was surprised at because I think Fairfax has played three really good games. Unfortunately, in this game, the officials were a little erratic. They never adjusted, Fairfax did. And it cost them. I mean, Westchester, give them credit. They made 29 free throws out of 34. But I just felt the officiating, for whatever reason, was not up to the par for a City Section semifinal game. And Fairfax came out because of that. But also, Westchester was much more aggressive. They rebounded much better than before. Kirk Smith, they took him out of the game. The previous two games for Fairfax, he was the key player. And without him, Fairfax couldn't beat Westchester.
Yeah, he fouled out early in that game. Let's turn our attention to the girls' bracket. Palisades, the number two seed, easily over El Camino Real.
Yeah, just Torino Johnson has his team always playing well at this point in the season. Chelsea Gibson's the best player in the City Section. They get to play Fairfax in a rematch. They lost to Fairfax a couple weeks ago, but I thought Granada Hills should have beaten Fairfax, but somehow Fairfax came back and won in overtime to keep Judy Edwards alive again. This is the second time she's come out of retirement. She's going to try and beat Palisades. She's predicting a victory.
Well, she beat them in the regular season, but you got to like Pally, who's trying for their third straight championship. She pulled a rabbit out of the hat, though, against Granada Hills. They were down by 7 fairly late in that game. And in the southern section, here we have Bishop Montgomery over Sierra Canyon 70-63 and Modern Day over Chino Hills 83-80 in overtime, both surprises.
It doesn't matter what a surprise. What I remember most is being at the Galen Center, sold out. The fans were magnificent. They enjoyed so much.
You told me that it would be Sierra Canyon and Chino Hills. I'm looking at my notes.
Excuse me. It was a week of upsets except for Birmingham. And Chino Hills, I still don't know how they didn't lose, how they lost the game. They had opportunities to win at the end of regulation. They had opportunities to win in overtime. But Modern Day, Spencer Freeman had a great game and did a great job. And I still think Chino Hills will see them in Sacramento because they're going to come back and win it all in the regionals.
We'll see how they do in this state. Anyway, we're going to step out. When we come back, we'll talk with Nick Halick, the head coach here at Birmingham, and his fine point guard, Deshaun Winston. That's next on SoCal Prep Report.
Exploring LA County's trails is now a click away. A mobile-friendly trail locator lets you discover all our county's scenic hikes. It features an interactive map that takes you inside the trail. From the elevation to the temperature, what you need to know is at your fingertips. Wondering if your dog, horse, or bike is welcome? It has that too. So discover some of LA's best-kept secrets and happy trails to you.
The Birmingham Patriots, the top seed in the LA City Section Open Division, into the finals. No surprise there. Big-time semifinal victory over Taft. With us, the head coach, Nick Halick. He's done a nice job in his 5 years. And his outstanding guard, Deshaun Winston. I'll start with the coach. 17 straight victories, a lot of momentum. You've already beaten the team you're going to play in the finals, Westchester. But you don't think you're the favorite.
No, I mean, they're defending champions, you know. We're going to have a lot of work to do against them. They're a really good team. And so, you know, we're not looking at it like that.
Deshaun, you defeated Westchester 84-74 in the first go-around. What about Westchester makes them so tough?
Well, they're a hard-playing team, and they always compete, and they're always in the city championship almost every year. So we're really going to have to knock them off this time.
Coach Halleck, you know, this player next to me has had a great year. He's improved so much from last season. Could you just talk a little bit about his development as a player, both on the court and off?
I mean, off the court, he's always been a really great kid. I think on the court, his biggest development has been, you know, being able to score at all three levels. He can get a layup. He can hit shots at the three-point line, and he's got a great mid-range game. He's just a good leader. He's always under control. He's very, very coachable, easy to talk to. So, you know, I'm really proud of how he's done.
And Deshaun, you know, to win a city title, you got to have great play at point guard business. And I remember the Taft days when they had the Drew. Larry Drew did a great job. You've developed your versatility and stuff. You had 43 points in one game this year, but you also have had a lot of assists. Explain your role as a point guard out there for Birmingham.
Just getting all my players involved and whoever's hot, feeding them and make sure we're moving the ball and running our plays and keep moving it fast, because that's the way we like to play.
I want to talk about defense, because championships are won by defense. And in the semifinals, you beat Taft for the fourth straight time this year. And in the first three games, you did a lot of it with the offense. But I thought your defense against Taft in the semis was outstanding. You shut them down.
Yeah, I mean, they're really good. And, you know, we knew it was going to be difficult. We knew, you know, playing somebody for a fourth time, they were going to be up to the challenge. And they responded really well defensively. I think a lot of versatility for him. You know, he can guard a one or he can guard a two. We have a lot of other players that are versatile as well, so it helps us matchup-wise.
Pressure defense, that's your calling card.
Yeah, we want to play fast, so we want to keep the pace up, and it helps us with that.
Deshaun, back when you were a freshman, you were attending El Camino Real. They beat Westchester for the city championship, I believe, correct?
Yes.
And you were up in the stands, and now you get to play in the city championship games. How exciting is that for you and the team?
It's really exciting, especially for me, because this is my first time being here, and for the team, this is doing something big for the school, and it's bigger than us. It's for the school.
Right, and one of the strengths of this team is it's senior dominated, and you guys are very unselfish. Can you explain just how you got that unselfishness that spread throughout the team? Because that's kind of important to win.
Honestly, we always play together. We played summer with each other for pro skills, and that's how we played there, and we just carried it over to Birmingham.
And Nick, I know, Nick, you've said this is one of your funnest years because you haven't had to worry about a whole lot of things.
Yeah, no, I mean, like you said, with his club, they did played the same style. We carried it over when we played in Santa Barbara and different tournaments. So it's been very comfortable. I mean, really what we've coming into the season, it wasn't putting anything new in. It was just making what we were doing better. And, you know, that's the one biggest thing I'm proud of is that 20 assist mark, because they really are unselfish. And it's nothing it's not like we talk about it like, you know, you got to make sure you pass. That's just kind of what they do. So it's great to watch, and it's a great experience to coach them.
You know, I look up and there's banners in the arena, and they're all runner-up banners. Three different for basketball. You got a chance to put up a banner. You know how much that could mean to the school.
Yeah, I mean, be huge for the school, and more importantly, like a kid like Deshaun and all the kids on the team, you know, Abrams and Bolin and, you know, the Dutrees, all these guys really have committed to that goal. And, you know, they're one game away, and it's going to be the toughest game of the year, obviously. But, you know, it's something that I think they're up to the challenge. And, you know, doing that for the school, but more importantly for the kids, it'd be great. It'd be really special.
Deshaun, I know in this day and age, everybody talks about recruiting, and I know ASU is looking at you and other Pac-12 schools. How do you put that away for the time being and concentrate on the job you have to do Saturday night?
Well, honestly, nothing matters except for this game that's coming up, because that's going to come after the game, and you just got to stay focused on the game that's coming up. And that's pretty much how we deal with it. We just think of what's in front of us right now and not in front of the future. We just got to finish what we have here instead of thinking of what the next step is.
Well, Deshaun, congratulations on a great high school career. I know you'd like to play a number of more games, get into the state, and have some success. Coach Halleck, terrific job.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right, we're going to have some more from Birmingham. We're talking about this basketball team. Remember, they've won 17 straight. They haven't lost this year. You have to go back to 2016, late 2016, when they dropped a tight decision to Modern Day. More after this on SoCal Prep Report.
A single ember that escapes from a wildfire can travel more than a mile. You can't control where the ember will land, only what happens when it does. Get fire adapted now at fireadapted.org.
I don't know if this is the right term, but I'm going to call them the unsung heroes of a Birmingham team that's won 26 games. The bigger guys, not necessarily inside, because at Birmingham they run up and down the floor and they have different roles. Mark Bolin, who shoots a wonderful corner three, and we got Josh Abrams, who does a lot of the dirty work against guys like Antoine January of Taft. I'll start with Mark Bolin here. Mark, your thoughts about this basketball team and what you bring to this squad. I know you got the three stars, you got Deshaun Winston and the Dutrive brothers, but what do you bring to the team?
I feel like I not only bring my three-point shot, but I bring my composure to the team, as well as my scrappiness on defense, especially being down low and playing those bigger guys. We got to be a little more aggressive, got to be a little more tough, and we got to take him out of the game. And not only that, but just kind of sharing the ball around and being a team and being a unit.
Josh, I know in the last game of the semifinals, you had to work against the 6'9" Antoine January. He ended up scoring 24 points, but I thought you did a nice job confronting him inside. What was that like?
Yeah, definitely. I'm used to having to guard the big guy a lot. So when my team asked me to do that, I took on the challenge head on. And in the first half, he didn't score, so I did a pretty good job of that. But if another circumstance where I have to guard a big guy happens again, I'll be ready, and I'll do even better next time.
There's no really surprise that you guys are doing so well, because at the end of last year, you started playing very well, won a state game. What's the difference? Is it because everybody's back and just a lot better and gained a whole lot of experience last season?
Well, it's just the fact that we've been playing like together a lot. So with time, we got more chemistry. And last year, the ball would maybe stick more. But now that we're all used to each other and we're used to how we play, like the ball's moving a lot more. And it's showing in the games. Yeah.
Right. Mark, I noticed, you know, you're capable of scorer, but everybody on this team is capable of scoring. So you really have to be unselfish and try and find the open player and not get upset if you don't get the ball correct. I mean, how do you get that mentally to be able to be that unselfish?
Well, I mean, over the summer, we were really able to bond. I went over to their training camps and their travel ball team, so we were really able to bond and know each other's strengths. So I think it was a lot easier coming into this year, being able to pass the ball around and just be the way we are, being unselfish with our 20 assists a game. It was real easy for us to do that because we just knew where everyone was going to be. We knew what everyone wanted to do. So it was real easy coming into the season.
You guys have played a very grueling schedule, some of the top teams in Southern California, both the Southern section and city schools. So I think that's going to help bode well as you face a team like Westchester. Your thoughts about the approach to the championship game?
Well, my thoughts are definitely they're going to be back. You know, we versed them in the Pac Shores tournament, same kind of situation with the championship game on the line. And we answered. You know, we were down in the first half. We were down most of the game, but we came back. And I think the best thing for a team like Westchester, you know, they have a lot of playoff experience, a lot of championship experience. But I think if we play together and we push for it, we push the ball up the court, we pass it around, we share it, we got a good chance of winning this whole thing.
Josh, your thoughts on the finals?
I think if we just rebound, execute on offense, and play defense, take care of business basically, play the way we play and not try to do anything different than we've been doing, then we should come out with a win.
Well, gentlemen, congratulations on a terrific year, 26-3 against that grueling schedule. I see Mark's got a smile on his face, and so does Josh. You should. You guys have played really well and represented this school magnificently. That's Mark Bolin and Josh Abrams. We'll have more right after this on SoCal Prep Report.
What's happening, LA? I'm Arian Alexander. Start out March strong as we've got you covered for all the fun events in LA this week. Check it out. Starting this Thursday, you're invited to enjoy lunchtime concerts at Grand Park. You'll be treated to young Angeleno artists as they voice their creativity and expressions through music. As part of Our LA Voices, a season-wide celebration, you can attend these concerts for free until the end of May. There will also be food trucks offering some of LA's best street food. Go to grandparkla.org for the full calendar. This Saturday, head over to the Griffith Observatory for their monthly star party. The event is a great chance for the whole family to try out a variety of telescopes and look at the sun, moon, and visible objects of our solar system. You also get the chance to talk to knowledgeable amateur astronomers about the sky and their equipment. The event is always free, so come and observe the cosmos. Go to griffithobservatory.org for more information. The Great Rock and Roll Flea Market is taking over the Regent Theater in downtown LA this Sunday. This one-of-a-kind flea market is free to attend and open to all ages, with an impressive selection of vintage collectors, antiquities dealers, crafts makers, music memorabilia, and local food vendors. Happening on the first Sunday of every month, you've got to check it out. Go to theregenttheater.com for details. Whether it's stars on the stage or stars in the sky, there's plenty of events sure to make your week dazzle. I'm Arian Alexander for What's Happening in LA, and I'll see you next time.
Hi, everybody. I'm Rich Estrella, and welcome to the SoCal Prep Report. This is the Southern Section edition, and we're coming to you from the legendary wrestling room at Santa Fe High School. That's right. Santa Fe High School, has one of Southern California's richest traditions in wrestling. I think overall, we were charting this thing from the start, and Santa Fe is one of the top 25 high schools of all time in the state of California. And today we're joined by Coach Angel Molina, the head coach over at Santa Fe High School. Coach, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
All right, great tradition. You've been part of this tradition at Santa Fe High School, and now you are carrying out and carrying it on as far as the head coach. How long have you been here, and what's been happening?
This is my fourth year as head coach here, and I've been along with this program ever since I was born. My father, he grew up here, graduated class 1990 under Coach Tom Thompson, and now I'm here. I'm trying to just keep the tradition going.
If he was wrestling under Coach Thompson, man, he that's brutal. If he survived that, he must have been an animal.
Yes, he was very old school and ground and pound.
That's how you do it here. Okay, Coach, let's talk about your season. You guys won the Del Rio League this year. Been a long time since Santa Fe was challenged. It took a while for you guys to wrestle the crown back, but you guys have it now. It belongs to you.
Yes, it's our second year back-to-back champs. Hopefully keeping the tradition going and having it for another 10 to 20 years.
How have things changed, do you think? I know your pops was kind of probably some of the old school stuff. I know he wrestled under Coach Thompson. Coach Thompson wrestled under Sowers, who, you know, he was the guy that had the blueprint for all this. All right, so let's talk about some of the differences between possibly when your dad was wrestling compared to now, because I know how Thompson was. Thompson, you know, if he taught your dad, I'm sure he passed down some of those techniques to you.
Yes. So the kids have changed a little bit just with you know, generations change from time to time, but the tradition is still there. That was brought to me by my father and some of the old coaches that still pop their head in. So
you guys have a lot of guys returning next year.
Yes.
Talk about that.
Yes, we have about 8 to 9 guys returning from this year's championship team to next year's team. So it's going to be alive and well.
Wow. All right, so let's go ahead and meet. You have, a contender at 152 pounds, Ronnie Peraza, and he's going to go to state. Talk about him.
Been a tough kid. He came in as a freshman, first year wrestler, and from then on, he every day put in his time. He's been to a couple of camps. He had a brother that kind of showed him the way of work ethic, and then from there, just kept moving on.
It's always great having that older brother show you the work ethic, isn't it, Ronnie? It's always great, man, because your brother will thump you harder than anybody will thump you, and nobody else better thump you, because your brother will thump that guy harder than anybody's ever thumped in as well. So it's great having brothers.
Yes.
It's been the program, and especially when they're up and coming. All right, let's meet Ronnie. Ronnie, come on up, man. Okay, we're talking with Ronnie Peraza, and of course, Ronnie is the Del Rio League champion, and he's headed to state, qualified at the Masters. Ronnie, first of all, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
All right, so you had an older brother who wrestled. So let's talk about that. I'm sure that had something to do with you being a state contender now.
Yeah, my brother would always rough me up, and during practice, he'd always just push me. He just always tell me to keep on going, and just like, he's always make me do better at practice every day.
Right. He talked to you at home and get you ready, because your brother was a pretty good wrestler too.
Yeah, he was. After practice, he'd always tell me, he's like, you always just gotta go out there after every tournament. He'd always tell me what I did wrong and everything.
Good.
And he would just always make me like make me feel good about myself and like just, oh, come on, you always got it and everything.
Almost like having a private coach, huh?
Yeah, he was just always telling me, it's like, oh, you got to do this. Like, no, sometimes don't move like this. You got to go over here. And it was just improve.
So let's talk about your rise this season. I was talking to Coach. He said, you know, he felt like maybe you were just a little slow getting out of the gate, but he totally expected you to be here now. So let's talk about your season.
Well, my season, I started off rough. I actually hurt my ankle in the beginning of the season. And I was just going through a couple of injuries, and I was just in my mind. And I just, my coach, one time my coach just told me after a loss, he was just like, you just got to step it up. And I just kept that in the back of my mind, just step it up, and just keep going forward.
Are you surprised you're here now? You surprised that you were the LRA League champion? You know, the titles in this league haven't been easily given anymore. Surprised you there, and you're surprised you're here now?
Yeah, I am surprised. I was thinking I was just like doing something good, but now I'm out here like doing something great, and I'm just trying to get improved, trying to be outstanding.
So let's talk about your teammates this year. Of course, you guys are, you know, you're underclass heavy this year because Coach says you have 8 returning lettermen that are going to get to wrestle again, and that's a lot. So talk about your teammates. How supportive have they been, and how have they helped you get here?
They've been really supportive. They're all just young kids. They're all just like sophomores, juniors. So I just sometimes I tell them to do something, but sometimes they're like, oh, hey, you're doing that wrong. And they're just like, it's like it works both ways, and we're both helping each other out.
Good. Well, listen, you've got a big task ahead of you coming up this weekend. You're going to be up at Bakersfield at the Rubble Bank Arena. It's going to be a big place, but you just wrestled in a big place at the Citizens Bank.
Yeah.
Ontario.
It was in the Citizens Bank Arena.
Isn't it crazy walking into a place like that? It's almost like you're walking into the Gladiators back at the Coliseum in Italy or something like that, or Rome, that is.
Yeah, it was like in a hockey rink, too, so I can see like all the events that happened the day before.
Yeah. All right, man. Well, listen, we want to wish you best of luck. Congratulations getting the state. Don't take it lightly, man. You have so much tradition. And I'm sure you're going to end up here when it's all over and done with. Well, once again, Ronnie, congratulations to you. We're definitely rooting for you. And good luck at state this weekend, man.
Thank you.
All right, Ronnie. Thanks again. All right. Just like to remind you, this weekend, of course, at the Rubber Bank Arena, it's the CIF State Wrestling Championships. If you're looking for some Southern California favorites, St. John Bosco has 8 wrestlers going. I believe Northview has 6. I do not think it's going to be enough to win the state this year. I think it's going to come out of the central section like it usually does. We always talk about the Terrapellis and Clovis. And, of course, there's Lamore up there, and then Buchanan's always good. So it's going to be a tall order this year. We'll see if Bosco can do it. We'll see maybe Northview can do it. Maybe they get 6 and 8 state champs out of it. I doubt it. Okay. We are going to leave you now taking a look at the CIF Southern Section basketball playoffs. Of course, they're going to be in 3 different spots. Times are all over the place. So instead of trying to just repeat it here, take a look at the graphics and be sure you get out there and watch some great basketball this weekend. We'll see you next week. We'll have a look at the finalists in the CIF Southern Section basketball. We'll probably have the state playoff pairings, and we'll also have an update on how Ronnie Peraza did at state and who won state this year in the wrestling in California.
So, I got this new family, and I don't know what it is about this one, but she can't seem to put down that toy. Oh, and she even talks to it. Who's she talking to? Her mom? She talks to her mom a lot.
Need to mention, the Crenshaw Cougars won a city title last year. It wasn't the open division. They have a chance to win again. It's their 26th final. They're going to take on Granada Hills in D1, looking for their 18th overall championship.
Yeah, Granada was the big surprise. They knocked off Fremont on Uni. I still think Crenshaw's the big favorite. They have some very good physical players out there, but Granada, Don Operino does a great job. He's going to try and pull off the upset.
And now I want to get your comment. You mentioned it on the top of the show. You like Birmingham in the open division to beat Westchester.
I've liked Birmingham all season. I was there back at Redondo when the season began in November when they beat Westchester. I saw the potential that Birmingham had because they have five players who can score anywhere. Westchester has obviously the experience, the great coach in Ed Azam. They will need to pull off a huge upset to beat Birmingham.
Now in the girls' game, the Pally-Fairfax rematch, remember Fairfax won the last time, Kayla Williams, Chelsea Gibson, I like those two,
yeah,
I like Pally.
That's the combo that is very hard to stop.
Basketball just about over. Baseball is beginning. My Huskies, North Hollywood, 3-0, Eric.
Oh, they started really well, Randy, but when they play somebody good, we'll see what happens.
You're just going to slough that off, huh?
But last week, Chatsworth opened up. Great performance by Thomas Gutierrez. He had 12 strikeouts in his opener. El Camino won. Those are the two top teams in the city, and then we'll see who else develops here.
Birmingham did lose a baseball game to Saugus, though.
But Eduardo Rosales threw shutout ball into the seventh. So there's some good pitchers, and it's early. Let's hope the rain isn't around and everybody gets to keep playing.
Why would you think there'd be rain in Southern California? What has given you that impression?
Randy.
We'll get all the games in this year,
okay,
Eric.
Okay, good for you.
I finally caught him off guard, and it's even
No.
Baseball.
I don't even want to discuss the weather, okay? I do not want to discuss the weather.
Next week, we're going to talk about the Division III finals. We'll see if Van Nuys or Sotomayor will have a city championship in D3. For Eric Sonheimer, I'm Randy Rosenblum. We'll see you next time right here on SoCal Prep Report.
What's happening, LA? I'm Arian Alexander. Start out March strong as we've got you covered for all the fun events in LA this week. Check it out. Starting this Thursday, you're invited to enjoy lunchtime concerts at Grand Park. You'll be treated to young Angelino artists as they voice their creativity and expressions through music. As part of Our LA Voices, a season-wide celebration, you can attend these concerts for free until the end of May. There will also be food trucks offering some of LA's best street food. Go to grandparkla.org for the full calendar. This Saturday, head over to the Griffith Observatory for their monthly star party. The event is a great chance for the whole family to try out a variety of telescopes and look at the sun, moon, and visible objects of our solar system. You also get the chance to talk to knowledgeable amateur astronomers about the sky and their equipment. The event is always free, so come and observe the cosmos. Go to griffithobservatory.org for more information. The Great Rock and Roll Flea Market is taking over the Regent Theater in downtown LA this Sunday. This one-of-a-kind flea market is free to attend and open to all ages, with an impressive selection of vintage collectors, antiquities dealers, crafts makers, music memorabilia, and local food vendors. Happening on the first Sunday of every month, you've got to check it out. Go to theregenttheater.com for details. Whether it's stars on the stage or stars in the sky, there's plenty of events sure to make your week dazzle. I'm Arian Alexander for What's Happening in LA, and I'll see you next time.